Okay. So we're back here. Yeah, IDs after that little fun, terrible escapade and waste of time. Now I should really do something to move forward again. And that will be the changing of this thing. Like these very basic parts of YAML resource core or whatever. I want to get like the entity and whatever information from this. I'm going to move this into the ECS, libyaml, like into here. So it'll be like ID info, I think, is what I'm saying. So it can read and write ID info to and from YAML. That's the idea anyways. So let us begin. I have this right. That, yeah. So we're going to be reading two. Basically, it is almost basically this exactly, except it's not going to be. It's going to be foeID YAML export. It's going to be the same pattern as this, rather. So the YAML read. Will we be giving the node in, or will we actually like have it as a subnode? It'll be the node that it's on. We're going to simplify. Simplify. Which would also mean what? Okay. Foeid, I think is what I call it. Just foeid. Sorry, where's ID? Where's it gone? Where'd it go? Am I crazy? Oh, it's down there still. Ooh, not great. Move it back into there. Did I accidentally, like, already submitted something with it in that new location, didn't I? You idiot. When did I? Okay, hold on. Actually, undo that. Foeentity ID to foeID, which means it was done as part of the last one. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to move it. We're going to reset all those other items, which I presume were also modified as part of the last. Uh, ECS editor names, I presume. Okay. Okay, so that's looking okay-ish. Let's go ahead and groups. You've been modified. That fixes up the last one. Is there anything else I'm missing? Not really. These are all new items. Editor name map stuff. Okay. Back to ID info. We got these two functions. So that no you two. There we go. Well, come on. foeID group equals, okay, this is where we're going to need some things of input. We need to like foeID. We're going to have to say group ID is like what? The input group, the requested group, the... The what group? Come on. Come on. Input group, requested group, targeted group. Index ID, we got the YAML read required. For parsing, okay. So basically is this. So it won't be that, it'll be a mixture of both. We wouldn't actually, would we? We wouldn't want to do this because we'd only want to add the data if we find it, or if we're going to successfully complete the rest of the operations. Okay, no, actually for now, I'll just leave it like this. Okay, when I'm bringing in stuff, I'm going to be importing. I have a translation layer. Now, do I need that? Import state data from file as part of the target group. This is because I have group translations. Okay, I'm going to have something a bit more real for group translations now, aren't I? Oh, yeah. This is, goes insane. Insanity. This is all insanity. If we do that, then ID group equals foeics normalized to group ID for whatever ID group is retrieved. And ID equals group and ID index. Now, do I want to add type? Probably will. But not yet. Not quite yet. We want to do don't even need to be a reference. I've got so much stuff opened here. Targeted group. If targeted group now. If it's not the same group, then we need to print out whatever the group ID is right now. And we got the editor name, so if you find it. It's not empty. Then we put it out. Do that, then we print that out, and then auto that. That should be, oh. Okay, we go down to application. We're going to swap out that piece for armature. Info, which is node, ID, and that. Constant, unsigned int, editor ID map. Okay. Oh, I'm missing this. So, okay, for the moment, don't have it because it's not useful. Okay, and that means we can get rid of the resource ones. So resource HPP, and this one, these two go away. That is removed. What's with Armature Public? This has got an extra header for some reason from an earlier attempt at something, no doubt. So one thing we want to do is we want to add the editor name map. That and the test for it. Make sure. Actually builds. Run the tests. Cool. I got problems with YAML parsing now. And something else. ECS test for groups. Probably the... This is some very different numbers. Okay, I'm going to have to... Damn it! Okay, so anything, that's just index generator stuff, right? Group stuff, and not to do with what I just added. So we'll add those. We'll kind of flip back and figure out what's going on here. Opposed to simulations are not. Internalizing. which is that. Okay. Okay, I'm going to add that. ECS, notes, ID info. ID info, ID data, it sounds more like it. Just that. So it's ID, that. Index info and what? Actually, that doesn't make any sense. What really does make sense is not equal a foeICS groups persistent. So I'm going to need to include that. If it's also means the ID header. We can just that and that. Not quite. Why is it taking so long to link? Is it is it static again? It may be static again. Res ID is like, what is this? Out of what? What file? What file? 12 test. Really? Really, really, really. Okay, we're going inside. Oh, yes. Yeah, of course, that. Okay, all right. Bam. Okay. All right, with that done, what else? I have to do groups, search paths. Okay, in order for this to work, I need two or three. Okay, I need to get translations. I need to bring translations up to the ECS level as well, because I need to keep that around if I'm going to be loading stuff after the initial load, basically because of resources. It's not necessarily required for state data, but for resources, it is. Or is it? No, it is. It will have to be, because I'll still need to be able to translate. I mean, it is just basically this, isn't it? So what I can do, it should be pretty easy. Keep that, close others. Close others, and then we'll just go up to here, and we have like a group translation. I need to keep it on a more permanent basis. Much like I need to keep the search paths for the other items as well. So, now, do I need to? What is it? It's basically just this, right? It's still just this. So, or translation. Yeah, I'll just leave it at this struct. Maybe a map. I mean, they're all pretty small. know what? I'd rather just have a very small footprint, the smallest, and I'll just go through it the old-fashioned way. I mean, if it's like a dozen, couple... it's usually going to be one or two entries, maybe a couple dozen entries. It's so fast to go through, and this is such a rare operation in the grand scheme of things. I'd rather just have the memory footprint of the whole thing in a nice, small, compact, quick to iterate through array, well, vector list, rather than do anything fancy with a map or an ordered map or anything like that. So, ECS export, ID. Normalized, regular, normalized, it's just regular, it's not normalized. So I'm going to say, close that up, don't need it for that. Translation. Now this is used right about here, I believe. So something like this. Do I have compile commands? Yes, I do. Imagine it's SOA. Okay, they're mostly, that's, yeah. Okay, they'll all be mostly shared objects now, so it'll be a bit faster. And then we want to move that over. Change that up a little bit. It fixed up, so then we have do that. Normalized source group. That's basically it. Very small. Loosen like that for the moment. Okay, we need some way to set up the group translation. So, how did I build up the translation in the first place? Okay, so let's say I have this already, this list. Group translation. Call this set. So what I want to do is import it through that for the moment. Find all locations where it needs to be updated. Okay. Okay, then we get rid of this file entirely. Instead, we'll have to find the file. Okay. Because right now, where's the name? Where are the names associated with this stuff? Index generator, right? For some reason. Yeah, it's part of the name. Index generator is being overloaded with too much stuff. Okay. So, how am I going to generate this stuff? How? Really, I don't really want to keep state data dependency, because right now that's going to be swapped out with this. This needs to be replaced with a more permanent group solution. That I keep, like, I need to have the name, I need to have the group, and I need to have the ability to access the date, the group data. At all times. So this stuff I can just like put into an ECS, into the ECS groups class as well. Okay, let me grab a drink and come back to this in a moment. I'll put it on pause. Okay. But for the moment, what I'm going to do, I'm going to move this over just for the moment so that I can actually like generate, maybe, I mean, this is the thing I use, right, to generate ECS export. We'll just like generate. Something like that. Okay, we have that. You will down here. We'll move, get this, wherever this is from here. Bam. Okay, yeah, I'll work with this. And then, oh, I already have it actually. Do a const and for a moment, or rather just a reference, and ID groups. Okay, so what we're going to do is instead of this, we're going to use here. Into there. group ID equals that. Okay. Let's add this up or add this in. Not this. This. Okay, just need to update. Translations. Of the simulation. And I imagine I could also use this to apply it to entity data as well. If I can do this right, I can also probably stream in and out entity data. I think, but this infrastructure is mostly for resources. Okay, no, that is a YAML. That's why that's there. Editor name map. That's not even implemented yet. That's there for search paths. Okay, let's get this search path stuff in so I can actually make things a bit easier to work with. So, Don't really use the ECS name map for anything, do I? Okay, so then there's not really that much point in bringing that in quite yet. So the next item really is either removing names or fixing this up. I think I'll remove names first. They're just not used at all, really, anymore. Oh, no, because that requires the ECS name map. Or does it actually require it? No, it doesn't require it. Not yet. Okay. So removing names. Does this mean we even really need string view or string? Nope. Goes name. It's required for that at least. We don't need the string view, we just need the string. It's ready to go. There it is. You need string, but not string view. Same deal. Almost there. Okay, that just leaves we need to find the constructor locations and and the pools. Remove them from the pools as well. Need to do something about shader loader now, I think. Or would we? Would we? I'm not entirely sure. Curious. Okay, what is the function called specifically? Really, you don't have foeID at this point? Interesting. Okay, so this is where I would be doing the other thing. See, this wouldn't actually be part of this function. This, wherever this is actually called from, if anywhere, not this, it'll be get material. Okay, how would I do the declaration? It'd be just like the ID info, wouldn't it? And I just want the ID info. I wouldn't want the string name to go here in the declaration of a material. So I need to split that ID info function. I need to the two constituent parts. ID, which can be group ID, maybe type in ID in the future, and then index ID, and then editor name would be entirely separate. Yeah. Okay, read ID. Editor name. So rather than this, we'll just pass the name back and forth, really. Yeah. I think. Or. No, I don't even really need it. I don't need this. Just like that. Because it's just a string by itself. That's it. So I don't actually really need any fancy stuff to go along with it. foeID. If we fail, we throwing anyways. Looks like Clang D decided to break. Yeah. So close that, reopen it. Save it. Save it. Okay, we're all fixed up. Avoid that. The node I'm currently on. Okay. That we're still going through with these, which is great. Get ID. That's why we just do this for the moment, yeah? It's not actually using it. This one is, though, so I may as well fix it here while I'm at it. Dang. Material declaration. Image declaration. I've kind of put myself in a weird little deal here. Declaration. Put on the current node or a sub node that I create. And it's a two part. Okay, I can at least get rid of this. Writing material definition. Don't need it here. Like, really, it should be this. Well, not this. Whatever the right version is. The writing one is, I should say. That's also completely wrong. Okay. Okay, get rid of the name part. Same thing here. We've got problems down here. Okay, got a whole bunch of little changes. Let's make sure it still works. Oh, thank God. Yes. Okay. Yeah, undo that one. Not using it. Better control. Okay. Armature pool. Let's just run cd build. Make format. Okay. String view, string view.
Okay.
Okay. Sources. For runtime, just that. It just is. Okay, that. Search paths, groups. Okay. Getting really close to the where I'm going to actually have to deal with this group importer system. In fact, I'm pretty sure I'm just on it now, really, where I need to shift all that YAML file interaction from the resource libyaml to outside. But I'll do that another day, because this is already long enough today. Cheers.